Hello all, myself Chandil Popat. Let us begin new chapter, which is bearing capacity. Now, what is bearing capacity? So there is a capacity to bear. Bear what? To bear load from building, or we can say structure. So we are talking about soil's capacity to bear the load. There is soil bearing capacity. There is SBC. Let us begin this chapter from basic definitions. So first, there is footing. Footing is the lowest portion of the foundation of a structure that transmits loads directly to the soil. So it is the most bottom portion of foundation. Second one, what is foundation now? A foundation is that part of a structure which is in direct contact with soil and transmits load of superstructure to the ground. So there is a upper portion of footing, we can say, or which directly is in contact with superstructure to ground. Third one, there is bearing capacity. It is defined as the load carrying capacity of foundation of soil. Gross bearing capacity, that is known as small q. Total pressure acting at the base of the footing, including weight of the superstructure, self weight of footing, and weight of fill, which is laid over the footing, is known as gross bearing capacity. Basically, gross means overall, total. Net bearing capacity, which is symbolized as Q and in suffix N, Qn. It is defined as gross bearing capacity minus the original overburden pressure at foundation level. So basically, overburden at foundation level should be subtracted from gross pressure, and formula for that we can say Qn is equal to Q minus gamma into D, where gamma is of overburden. Let us move further. Sixth definition, that is ultimate bearing capacity, Qu. It is defined as the gross pressure at the base of foundation level. So now we are talking about the base of foundation level. Net ultimate bearing capacity, Qnu. It is defined as the net pressure in excess of the surcharge pressure at which the soil falls in shear. So, it is the pressure when soil falls in shear, that means it breaks. It is equal to gross pressure minus surcharge pressure. So, this is net ultimate. We can say with formula, there is Qnu is equal to Qu minus gamma into D, where Qu, that is ultimate bearing capacity, gamma, that is unit weight of foundation of soil, D, that is depth of foundation, and gamma D, that is overburden pressure, or we can say surcharge. Its definition, that is net safe bearing capacity. Now, net and safe, both are together. That is known as Qns. It is defined as the load per unit area in excess of surcharge pressure, which the foundation soil or bed can carry safely without any risk of the failure. So we are talking about safe, and which is net pressure. Let us move further. So safe bearing capacity, Qs. It is the maximum gross pressure which the soil can carry safely without shear failure. It is equal to the net safe bearing capacity plus the original overburden or surcharge pressure. Let us write by formula, Qs is equal to Qnu upon F plus gamma into D, where F is what? F is factor of safety. So Qnu, that is net ultimate capacity, when we divide net ultimate by factor of safety, it becomes net safe capacity. So Qs is equal to Qns plus gamma into D. Next, net safe settlement pressure. Now we are talking about settlement of foundation, settlement pressure, Qnp. It is a net pressure which the soil can carry without exceeding the allowable settlement. So, without exceeding allowable settlement, whatever the pressure soil can carry, that is net safe settlement pressure. Allowable bearing pressure, Qa. It is net loading intensity at which the foundation of soil neither falls in shear nor there is excessive settlement. So we can say in between both the situations, that is detrimental to the structure. So this is how we can define basics of this chapter. All basics will be revised when we will move into theories. So let us move further. Methods of determining bearing capacity. So basically we can divide these methods into three portions. First, there is IS code method, which is Indian standard code method. It is used widely in India. Analytical methods as well as field methods. Now IS code method IS 1904 has given standard method to calculate this, as well as analytical methods like Terzaghi's theory, Rankine's theory, other Prandtl method. These are popular ones. Among them, Terzaghi's theory as well as Rankine's theory are most popular. Field methods, plate load test, SPT, SCPT, DCPT as well as pressure meter test. These are popular field tests. Among them, plate load test is most popular. Let us move further. Modes of shear failure. So the first one is general shear failure. You can see this image is showing general shear failure. In case of general shear failure, if the soil is loaded and their properties are like, if upon loading the soil behaves like in this figure, the pressure becomes more lethal and outside, or we can say outskirts of the area which is being loaded, it also bulges out, then it is general shear failure. Local shear failure. In case of local shear failure, you can see this image. Upon loading or to the foundation, in local shear failure, the soil behaves like before developing full plastic zones, it gets like this, fails or breaks in shear, and bulging is minimal in this case. Punching shear failure is the next one. You can see here only like a punching of a punch of steel and a hammer, it behaves like a punching, or we can say a cone is generated. So it is a example of punching shear failure. So moving further, after these modes of failure, most important ones are general shear failure and local shear failure. These are for your basic idea of failures of foundation, and design is always considered according to failures. How the building or structure or foundation is getting failed, and that is how you will design the building or structure or foundation, whatever you are designing. Let us move further. General shear failure versus local shear failure. Let us see differentiation between both of them. So in case of general shear failure, as we have seen in the figure, it occurs at low strain, less than 5%, where local shear failure will happen when it is a higher strain, like 10 to 20%. General shear failure will happen when angle of shearing resistance is greater than 36, where local shear failure will happen when the angle of shearing resistance, which is denoted by phi, will be lesser than 29%. So this is how you can say it is a case of general or local shear failure. SPT, standard penetration test value, is greater than 30, then it is a general failure. And if it is less than 5 SPT value, SPT is nothing but a test. If the test gives results which is n is less than 5, number of blows is less than 5, then it is a local shear failure. Now density index ID, which we have found out in index properties, is greater than 70, then it is a case of general shear failure. If it is less than 20, then it is a local shear failure. Now from load versus settlement curve, you can say for the failure point is well defined in case of general shear failure, but in local shear failure it is not very well defined. In general one, the C and phi are the basic soil parameters, where here soil parameters C will be converted into C dash, and C dash total cohesion constant will be 2/3 of C, as well as phi will be given as phi dash, and it will be 10 inverse 2/3 of 10 phi. So this is how it changes to general shear failure to local shear failure. If void ratio is greater than 0.75, then it is a general shear failure. But if it is a greater than 0.75, it is definitely a local shear failure. So this is how you can differentiate both of them. General shear failure occurs in dense stem or stiff clay, where local shear will happen in clayey soils of medium compaction. General shear failure will happen in extreme cases, either in dense sand or stiff clay, but in mediated cases, local shear failure will happen like this. Moving forward, factors affecting bearing capacity. So, in factors, first factor is position of groundwater table. Now, groundwater table, if it is very less or very low, the capacity will be same. But if it increases and reaches up to your foundation, it may get decreased. So this is how groundwater table variation will change your bearing capacity. Relative density or angle of shearing resistance. Here, relative density of soil depends upon angle of shearing resistance, which is phi. If your phi is greater, it affects your foundation differently, your capacity differently. If your phi is lesser, it will again behave differently. Width of footing. Now, if the width of the footing is greater, there is no issue. But if it is lesser, if your foundation is less in the width, it may happen that it gets failed easily. Same with depth of the footing. If not given appropriate depth of the footing, the bearing capacity will be less. Or we can say thickness of the footing matters in the bearing capacity of foundation. Unit weight of soil. So if the soil which is there, if it is having more unit weight, it will be having lesser capacity. If it is having lesser unit weight, it will be having more capacity. Eccentricity of load. If the load is eccentric, it will behave, your foundation will behave differently, and the loading will be eccentric, the risk will be more. So these are factors of affecting bearing capacity. You will understand these all factors when we will move to IS code method as well as Terzaghi's method. Let us move forward to plate load test. Now this is a test performed like this. Here you can see sandbags above whole assembly. Sandbags will help in giving load to the soil. Now this girders, it is a horizontal girder which will give, steel girder which will give load on this plate. Now this plate is very important in this test. This plate is taken as 1/5 of this width of the foundation, or we can say according to this plate, 5 times width have been dug out. We can say BF is equal to 5 into BP, where BP, that is plate width, breadth of the plate, and 5 times BP, that is BF, breadth of the foundation. So here dial gauges are put, this is called a test pit. Dial gauges are put to measure its displacement, its settlement. Now hydraulic jack is there, extension pipe for that is also there. Hydraulic jack will do what? In cars, in motors, jack is doing what? It is uplifting your car. Here, it will be giving downwards force to the foundation of your soil. Now, here, plate load test is performed for two things, settlement and bearing capacity. So, let us see the formulas. Before going to the formulas, let us understand one thing. The plate is kept in some scale. Let us see that. Small square hole is dug out. Okay. Size of bearing plate should be 30 cm by 30 or 75 by 70. This is our standard ones. Now, DF by DP will be BF by BP. Now, D is what? Depth of foundation upon depth of plate is equal to breadth of foundation upon breadth of plate. So whenever you are taking some plate dimension, you should take according to your foundation size, and the breadth and depth of your foundation should be scaled down. If your breadth is 10 and foundation breadth is 10 meter, as well as thickness is also 10 meter, so 10 by 10 meter, that means its ratio will be 1. Same way, you can take a plate having 10 centimeter breadth as well as 10 centimeter thickness, so the ratio will be maintained. Let us move to the formulas and let us move how to find out this. Now this assembly will give load to that, and according to that you will get results. From results you can say, for clay soils, if we talk about bearing capacity, Qf will be same as equal to Qp, where Qf is what? Where Qf is bearing capacity of foundation and Qp is bearing capacity of plate. So whatever the results of bearing capacity of plate will be there, same will be for foundation. For sandy soils, in case of sandy soils, Qf upon Qp is equal to Bf upon Vp. That means ratio of bearing capacity of foundation to plate will be same as breadth of foundation to breadth of plate. And you can use this formula anyways, and if you can make any Qf subject, if you make Qf as a subject of the equation, you can write this. Let us move to settlement now. For clay soils, settlement Sf is equal to Sp into Bf upon Vp. So settlement can be found out of foundation from plate values. Same way for sandy soils, if your soil is sandy, then Sf is equal to Sp upon 1 into bracket Bf into bracket Bp plus 0.3 square upon Bp into Bf plus 0.3 square. Here again, values of plate will be helpful to find out values of foundation, and this is the crux of this test. Although this test has some limitations, like the scaling effect, sometimes the scaling effect reduces the accuracy of results. Same way, if your judgment or if the test have human errors, you may assume that the foundation will behave like that, but it may not. So these are some of the limitations of this test. Let us keep our session up to this. We will understand more theories like Terzaghi's theories, IES code method in next videos. Thank you.